Greetings, greetings viewers and subscribers. So in today's journey, well, we were on our way to Mandeville and we had to stop recording because the phone that we were using to record, because of the sun, it was overheated. So we had to stop. We are now back in the parish of St. Elizabeth and we are heading towards Westmoreland. We are going to start this journey right at Middle Quarters. So sit back, relax and drive with me. Now, we were unable to put out any video yesterday. We had some other things that we had to deal with. So later on today, we are going to be coming up with the birthday greeting. So for persons who would have sent in greetings for yesterday, we are going to include them into today's birthday greeting. My apologies. Now, my viewers and my subscribers, between January 1 and January 7th, 2022, 37 murders were reported in Jamaica. And I say reported because some persons have gone missing. They have not been found. So, any game can play. So, officially, 37 murders were reported in Jamaica. It means that for the period January 1 to January 7th, over 5 persons were killed per day in Jamaica. Let that sink in a bit. The list of persons killed includes men, women, and children. We have been saying a lot of things. We have been talking about the leaders. We have been talking about the Prime Minister, the Commissioner of Police. We have been saying all kinds of things. We have been trying to blame everybody. The JLP can't manage. Andrew Holness can't manage. The Commissioner of Police should be fired. The Minister of National Security can't manage. There might be some truth in all of that. But my question for today is, my question to you, my viewers and my subscribers is, please, ask yourself this question. What am I doing to aid in the fight against crime and violence in Jamaica? Let me ask you again. Ask yourself this. What am I doing to aid in the fight against crime and violence in Jamaica? You don't have to tell me the answer, you know. But it's a question to be asked. What are we doing? Are we sitting back and blaming everybody else? And we are not doing anything? When we see, are we know certain things? Are we calling to report it? We are afraid. Afraid of what? Afraid of police calling up with name? But we don't have to tell no police anything. We can call 311. We can call the JDF tip line. We can call 119. We don't have to go on a station and go tell no police nothing. We can sit down in the comfort of our homes and pass on the information. Many of us, we know things. I get messages every single day. Sometimes you text me and I am unable to reply because of the amount of messages I get. Sometimes I have to just take a time out of the day and sit down and go through my phone. Believe me when I tell you, I can't respond to everybody. I cannot. So, people know things. Let us start playing our part. I mean, there are people who are setting up. There are people who are earning. There are people who are getting a salary to do certain things. But at the end of the day, most of the crimes that is taking place is not affecting them. It is affecting us. So ask yourself the question, what am I doing to aid or assist in the fight against crime and violence in Jamaica? If your answer is nothing, please change it to something. Let's start doing. So today we have a few stories for you. First up, that man that you're seeing on your screen, his name is Mr. Clarence Larson. He was 53 years old. In fact, Mr. Larson, He was supposed to be 54 years old next week, Monday, January 17th, 2022. Now, Sir Clarence, back in the day, he used to operate a music store. This music store was on Clark's Plaza in Savlamar. You know, when you're going down Great Jard Street and you pass Burger King. The first plaza going down Great Jard Street on the right-hand side. That's Clark's Plaza. So, Sir Clarence, back in the day, used to operate a music store on that plaza. We are told by at least one past student from Manning's High School that back in the day, she and her friends, they were music lovers. So when they leave school in the evenings, they would stop by that music store because he used to play some nice music. So, Mr. Clarence Larson, he lost his life in a motor vehicle accident yesterday morning, Monday, January 10th, some minutes to 8 o'clock. This accident, it took place along the Cave Main Road. The Cave Main Road is in the parish of Westmoreland. Now, our information is that Mr. Larson, he was accompanied by a passenger. He was driving the 1998 grey Toyota Lightyear. There was an accident along the Cave Main Road, you know, last week. It also involved a Toyota Lightyear. Two men died as a result of that accident. And the two men, they were in the Toyota Lightyear, the driver and the passenger. So in this accident, Mr. Larson, he was driving along the Cave Main Road. It is said that Mr. Larson, he was driving behind a black Toyota Isis motor car. We are learning that whilst Mr. Larson was going around the corner, he failed to negotiate the corner properly. As a result, he collided into the back of the Toyota Isis motor car. He lost control of the Toyota Lightyear and collided into another vehicle that was coming in the opposite direction. As a result, the vehicle that he was driving, the Toyota Lightyear, it overturned. Mr. Larson and the passenger, they received serious injuries. The passenger, we are told, he sustained a broken right leg. Mr. Larson, he received serious head injuries. Both Mr. Larson and the passenger, they were rushed to the Savlamar Hospital, where Mr. Clarence Larson, age 53 years old, he was pronounced dead. The passenger has been admitted in hospital in a stable condition. And like we said, he sustained a broken right leg. Sad indeed. May Mr. Clarence Larson's soul rest in peace. Now, onto the crime scene. This incident, it took place yesterday afternoon, Monday, January 10th, 2022, about some minutes after 2 p.m. It took place at Retirement. Now, Retirement is in the Granville Police area in the parish of St. James. Here is what we are learning. A team of police officers. It is said that this team of police officers, they saw a grey Toyota Fielder motor car with three men aboard driving along the main road. The team of police officers, they signaled this Toyota Fielder motor car to stop. However, the driver, he refused the police signal and sped away. The police, they chased this vehicle. The Toyota Fielder, it crashed along the Tucker Main Road. The hoodlums who were in this car, they managed to jump out of it and escaped. The police made checks in the area, but they were not found. When the police searched this vehicle, one extended Glock magazine containing 22 rounds of 9mm cartridges were found. We are learning that when these men jumped out of the car and ran away, all three of them had guns in their hands. So, this team of police officers, they may have prevented some murders yesterday. Because these guys, they were not going to praise and worship with these guns. They were heading somewhere. They were intercepted by the police. Police signaled them to stop. They managed to elude the police. The car crashed and they ran away with the guns. A magazine with 22 rounds was found. Congratulations to the Montego Bay Police for intercepting these hoodlums. Now, let's hope that the seizure of the motor car may lead to something. Let's hope that these hoodlums are identified and taken off the street. But in this next case, these persons were not so lucky. This incident took place yesterday, Monday, January 10th, sometime after 11 a.m. It took place along the Rock Main Road. Now, the Rock Main Road is in the Falmouth Police area in the parish of Trelawney. We are learning that a team of police officers, they were on spot check. They were conducting this spot check right in the vicinity of Glistening Waters. We are learning that the police officers, they signaled a Toyota Corolla motor car to stop. This car, it had three men aboard. The men were searched, as also the motor car, it was searched. During a search of this motor car, one Beretta pistol with the serial number intact, affixed with a magazine containing seven rounds of 9mm cartridges, was found in the car. As a result, the three men who were held in the car, one of them, he's 34 years old. He said he's a mechanic from New Road District. The other one, he's 32 years old. He gave his occupation also as a mechanic. He's from Lower York Street. He was the driver for the vehicle. Now, Lower York Street and New Road District is in the parish of St. Thomas. The third man, he's 41 years old and he's from Harbour Heights in Kingston. He gave his occupation as that of a fisherman. All three men, they were taken into police custody. We are not releasing their names yet because we are not sure whether or not the police charged them. So if and when we get that information, we'll be telling you their names. But this is what I have been talking about. Yeah man, this is what I have been talking about. I see some people come on and comment about what Justice Batts said about stop and search. Officers, who don't do the right thing. There's a thing named common sense. It is not taught in school. Do the right thing. Stop and search. The law says, as long as you have reasonable suspicion, you can do it. So ensure that you do some stop and search. Because if you were following what some people are saying, the gun in this car would not be found. So ensure that officers, when you use no common sense, stop and search. So once again, officers, congratulations. Enough respect. Now, in this next incident, it took place at a place named Pound Road. Now, Pound Road is in the Montpellier area, in the parish of St. James. It took place Sunday night, January 9th, 2022, almost 11 o'clock. Our information is that residents of Pound Road, they heard loud explosions sounding like gunshots. As a result, the police were called in. On the arrival of the police, a man, his first name is Michael. Michael was seen lying along the roadway. He was suffering from gunshot wounds to his abdomen. He was rushed to a nearby hospital where Michael, he was admitted in a serious condition. At the time we were recording this video, we hadn't gotten any update as to the status of Michael. But if anything changes, we'll be updating this story. The mayhem. The mayhem. Now, you remember that we carried a story last week where two brothers, Dervin and Sheldon Jones. Well, Dervin, he was 43 years old, and his brother, Sheldon, he was 41 years old. We told you that both of them, they were shot and taken out by hoodlums on Tuesday, January 4th, 2022. That day would have been Dervin's birthday. We are learning that the police, they took some men into custody. Now, the police, they are saying that they are searching for a man. This man, his name is Mark Phillips. He's popularly known as Fraghart. Now, Fraghart is from Riverhead District, Carowina, in the parish of Westmoreland. The police are also saying that Fraghart, he frequents Grooveland and Red Ground in Negril. They are saying that he also has connection in the parishes of St. Elizabeth and Clarendon. So, Fraghart, the police want you for questioning. They are saying that you should report to the Savlamar CIB no later than today at 6 p.m. Today, Tuesday, January 11th, 2022. Craggart, you need to go in and talk to the police. For the time being, they are saying that you're a person of interest. If you have nothing to hide, go in, go talk to the police. You can go in with a lawyer, or you can go in with a justice of the peace. Now, if you are here and you are watching this video, if you have not yet hit on the like button, remember to hit on it. If you have not yet subscribed to the channel, hit on the subscribe button, as also hit on the notification bell, then click all, so that whenever we upload a new video, you will be notified. And keep on telling a friend to tell a friend to subscribe to this channel, because over here we give you credible news, we go above and beyond to get our details and bring them to you. If we make a mistake, we are gonna come back and apologize. But learn this, we are not setting out to mislead anybody. We try our best to get authentic information and bring it to you. Now, in the final story for today, this incident took place last night, and we are going to be updating this story in a subsequent video, but we are going to give you the information that we have now. We have not yet gotten the names for the persons, so we are going to have to update this story. But so far, what we are getting is that this incident, it took place last night, Monday, January 10th, 2022, about 9 p.m. It took place at a place named Providence Heights in the parish of St. James. Here's what we are learning so far. It is said that three men, they traveled to Providence Heights. They traveled in that Nissan AD wagon motor car. Now, that Nissan AD wagon motor car that you are seeing on your screen, well, if you look carefully at it, you'll see that it's a taxi. It is a route taxi. Now, route taxis normally have the destination and the side of the car. And the side of that car is not easy for you to see, but halfway tree is written on the side of it. So, from all indication, that car plies the halfway tree route. So it's fair to assume that the car came from Kingston. The information we are getting is that the three occupants of the car, they are also from Kingston. You see, let me continue. Now, what we are learning is that the car, it went into the area of Providence Heights. They stopped somewhere along the road, when shortly after, another car with about four men inside of it came and met with them. They had a brief conversation, and shortly after, gunshots were heard. The men who came up in the car to meet those men, they opened fire in that car. All three men were hit. It is said that the men in the car, they then sped away. The police were called, and the three men, they were found inside of the car. They had received gunshot wounds to their head and their upper body. They were taken to the Cornwall Regional Hospital, where all three men were pronounced dead. Now, we don't get the details as yet, but the question is, these three men who journeyed from Kingston, what were they up to? They came to meet somebody. Who is it that they came to meet? Do you think this was a prayer meeting? I'm gathering the details. I am gathering the details. You see, sometimes we carry some story all the time, you know. We carry some stories all the while. And remember me tell you, if you pay attention to some of the stories that we carry, things like these cannot reach you. We carried at least two stories before of men leaving Kingston to come meet up with men in Montego Bay, and they were shot and killed. And in those stories, I'm not saying it's the same thing here, but those two stories that were brought to you, the men left Kingston to come to Montego Bay to buy guns. That is what happened in those two cases. Like I said, I don't have the information in this one yet, but my suspicion is those three men who left Kingston to meet up with these guys in Montego Bay. The mayhem continues. Blessed love, everybody.